Luckily, the canopy on Ultar's truck broke my fall.
Thank goodness for that.
The worst part of the experience was Ultar's driving.
What about the lens? Is it still in one piece?
Oh, yeah.
Well, it's good to see you again, Josh.
Really? Well, I have to say, I'd have enjoyed Syria a lot more if you'd been there.
I wouldn't have been much help. Anyway, you did just fine on your own.
I'll be back as soon as I can.
Okay.
I didn't recognize the biblical story in it. I was a Sunday school dropout. The statue had any secrets. It was concealing them pretty well. A statue of a knight holding a staff and a scroll. The lens fitted into the end of the scroll like a hand into a glove. Hey! A Knight Templar burning at the stake, and a date. Let me see. MCCCXIV. That's 1314. A scroll was a symbol of scholarship. I knew that much. A Knight Templar burning at the stake, and a date.
Excuse me, Father.
Pardon?
Do you mind if I ask you a few questions?
Not at all, monsieur. It will be my pleasure to help you.
Did you know that the center window conceals an image of a man burning at the stake?
The burning man?
What, you knew?
That there was a hidden image? No. But the church has a reputation for being haunted. Many times, people have claimed to have seen a burning man in the window. But when others, they look, there is nothing. Perhaps the light has to be just so for the figure to appear.
Yeah, or maybe you need a special lens. You must be proud to have such an incredible collection of stained glass.
Pride is a sin, monsieur. But it is hard not to marvel when the light shines through them. It is a fine example of the artisan's genius.
What do you know about the Knights Templar?
You have come to the right place, if that is your interest. Many of them were executed in the square outside. It was a disgrace to France.
Well, the Pope was right behind it, though.
Clement V was a man of mammon, not of God.
That's kind of forthright for a priest, isn't it?
You think so? It is hard to be sure what happened. It is so long ago.
Catch you later.
Au revoir, monsieur.
Hi, Andre.
Hello, Georgie.
What's with the long face?
Haven't you heard? The tripod was stolen.
No kidding.
I just don't get it. So many other treasures. And the thieves choose the tripod.
A modern-day alchemist, perhaps?
Who knows? There's no shortage of crazies in Paris. Hey, I visited Nicole's apartment.
Yeah, she told me you came by.
Ooh, quite a fine Georgie boy. I didn't expect anything quite so sexy.
I hope you're referring to the manuscript.
Oui, of course. Where have you been? Nicole said you were away.
I just returned from Syria.
Syria? On the trail of the Templars?
It's a long story, but I found the bull's head. It was referred to on the manuscript, remember?
Yes, what is it?
A secret cave built into a high cliff face. In the cave, I discovered a map bearing a phrase in Latin. In occidenta sita est in ora mundi.
The island of Britain.
Lies at the edge of the world, to the west.
Strange. That map seems to contain a series of pointers.
Like I said, it's a treasure map. What did you make of the manuscript?
It dates from the time of the Crusades.
We guessed that from the Templar seal.
It's a story and pictures like a modern-day comic book.
What story does the manuscript tell?
I don't know. It was probably produced for the tourist market.
Tourists?
Oh, oui, pilgrims in their thousands on their way to Jerusalem. The tourist trade is nothing new, you know. It's been around for centuries. Ever since Joshua made a packet selling souvenir bricks from the walls of Jericho.
Have you deciphered any of the images on the manuscript?
There's very little I can be sure about. The slang of the bull could be a reference to Mithras.
Who's he?
A Persian god, almost as popular as Christ at one time. The only thing I can be sure of is the knight. He's Spanish.
How can you tell that?
The writing on the shield, the reference to Ave Maria. No self-respecting knight from Northern Europe would have borne a coat of arms like that.
Can you identify the knight's coat of arms?
I already did, Georgie. He's a member of the De Vasconcelles family from the Costa Calida.
Were they famous?
No. They're not mentioned after the 15th century.
Oh.
The spotlight of history moved on. They are probably long dead.
Thanks for your help, Andre.
You're welcome.